Well, the most favorite part of the land use planning activities that we did was having the community members come and participate and look at all our very cool illustrative boards. The most rewarding part was seeing the elders come together and talking amongst each other and telling us where things were on the map. Also, for our nation staff coming together on day one, just sharing how they use the land historically, but also how they use the land today.
So one of the other activities that we had a unique opportunity is we had the kids from grade 6, 7, and 8 come over from the school. We reviewed with them a big map and laid the maps on the floor, and we talked about the cultural camp. And it was a great experience. So they ended up breaking out into 3 different groups. We had the 7 muskrats, we had the berry pickers, and a group full of the boys called Devil Ways. And one of the exciting things that we saw was just the kids initially were very timid and shy, but they really got into it and started drawing all over the plans and had a great time.
Well, the culture camp that's being built right now is a big investment for our nation. This is going to give us a very beautiful place, permanent place in the coming future for our children to partake in learning the traditional practices and methods of their Gukums and their Musums. And it's also going to give us an opportunity to show the natural beauty to everyone else outside of PTF and the Kum. So our culture camp is pretty significant. We're very happy that we were able to include that in our land use plan and get the kids planning.
This is Trout Lake's Exploring Land Use concept, and this concept was developed based on some preliminary maps and information that was gathered with the support of NRCan, as well as Peerless Trout First Nation and ISC, Indigenous Services Canada. We also had a survey that was conducted during treaty days, which gathered input from nation members about the types of houses, the type of activities they'd like to see within their community. And as they replied and gave those responses, we identified them and themed them into different categories, which were family infill, which would be where existing homes would be already. New residential areas would be new areas for development to accommodate residential. Commercial would be for commercial spaces for retail and such. The cultural and community facilities were another area. Future agricultural areas, which are currently not identified, future industrial areas, and also in this particular case, the Trout Lake to accommodate their clearing land use concept.
See on the family infill here, we can see where the families currently tend to live around each other. And we recognize that in our land use plan, community members have told us that this is what they want to continue. And we're putting that into our land use plan. Also, in the future, we're recognizing that we have these industrial areas and the agricultural areas that will, and these new residential and commercial areas and community cultural areas that will allow for new development and potentially for new sources of income and economic development. And also our park space here recognizes the importance of our water. Community members have told us that they want to conserve our beautiful rivers and lakes going through our community.
This is the Peerless Lake Plenary Land Use concept that was developed, similar to what was completed in Trout Lake.
And you can see we have our cultural and community facilities, our administration office, the new schools, the health center, and that's there and across the road. And down the road, we have our community, our potential commercial areas. And surrounding there, we have new residential areas. We also have our community and cultural areas where we have our rinks, our large community hall, our fire department. And we have our family infill where families are already living and families want to continue to live together. And also our industrial area where we can continue to grow our industry sector and potentially our agriculture area located west of the community. And of course, our beautiful park space, which will conserve our wetlands and all the habitat